Mr. President, you have referred to a multitude of problems in your address. You have commended some activities of the government, criticized others, and offered advice so that we may function better than we have so far done. We welcome your advice and the advice of others given with good intentions and with a view to improving conditions in the country. Anything that you suggest or your organization suggests will undoubtedly receive our most earnest attention. I am sure that you do not expect me to deal with the various matters you have discussed. Perhaps it would be more suitable to the occasion if I spoke to you about certain matters of basic importance, for we have to be clear in our minds about our basic social objectives. You will permit me to say something which I probably ought not to, and that is to confess that during the last few years we have not been very clear as to the direction in which we are going. In the immediate present, we might realize the importance of a particular step in the broader aspects of policy. Nevertheless, there is an enormous gulf between the immediate present and the future about which, in these changing circumstances, there is a great deal of difference of opinion in the country among those who have given thought to it. The fact is that vast new social forces are at work all over the world as a result of various developments, but mainly because of tremendous technological and political changes. In India and in Asia, large numbers of people have become politically conscious and refuse to submit as they did in the past. Tremendous social conflicts are taking place, and they sometimes lead to international conflicts. The great nations of the world are following economic policies that differ widely from one another. We may have a certain theoretical approach to problems, but that does little good unless it is related to the practical aspects of reality. Our approach must be fashioned by a study of existing conditions and our objectives, so that we can apply, if I may say so, the idealistic approach with a practical consideration of the problems prevailing in the country at a particular time. You will permit me to say that it is possible that our approach is a very limited one. It is possible that our approach derives from something static that belongs to the past and not so much from the proper appreciation of a situation that is changing and dynamic. Towards the end of your address, you referred in general terms to various objectives that we have. I suppose most of us would agree with those objectives, although of course some may go further than others. To say that we want greater wealth, higher standards of living, and greater production will not be contradicted. We have to achieve these objectives not merely mechanically, but also in a social sense, which is very important. I have been driven almost against my will to the conclusion that material well-being is just as important in human life as anything else.